talking about Pulse, but I want to take a step back for a second. And many of the platforms that people have been talking about, and much of the work that people have been describing, uses, when we scale the experiment, most of the versions of scaling here have been scaling things to web scale experiments, where what you're doing is just taking advantage of the fact that there's not a lot of people in your university subject participant pools or who you directly know. There's a lot of people online. You can contact them and recruit them much more easily and a much greater scale. But for many of the studies that, we tend to design our studies in such a way that it's plausible to do it with an internet-based sample, of like amateur users, for example. But for many of the studies that we and other fields run, it's not plausible to run the study using the MTurk population. So for example, if you wanted to go recruit people who had very little access to the internet, the MTurk population is a particularly bad sample to be using. At the degree of zero people that would qualify for your study. So what would you want to do if you wanted to do the kinds of like on-the-ground studies that right now involve, like many of you have run these, like sending a team of researchers to the Amazon or like to a small town in India to run a study, like average training study. Like how would you do that? How would you do a survey of people who, you know, maybe have good mobile phone access but don't have don't like regularly use the internet or don't want to sit down on your site? So what Pulse and hundreds of other organizations focus on is doing recruitment that's more local but not local where you are. Pulse has created a platform where they're able to do things like radio advertisements in otherwise hard to reach communities, where what they're offering is not US dollars, but mobile phone credits. So they've been able to do really interesting targeted recruitment of participant populations to understand things like the effects of like war on individual people's attitudes towards things, or like what are the effects of natural disasters on and how can technology assist? Or here's another question: like how do women receive healthcare information, what roles trust play, and high levels of maternity mortality in Eastern Africa? So they're able to recruit participants for research from various places in Eastern Africa for research. And so I think like, if you're interested in, I think it's like another way to think about scaling our experiments. IST Research, you're one good person to talk to if you're interested in trying to do a worldwide experiment that isn't well suited for the kinds of participants that are coming to your online experiments by default. Besides IST research, there are many other organizations doing this, though they're usually doing it at a more local level. So that, for example, I picked a few cities and asked, what would it be like to do targeted recruitment in Johannesburg? And yeah, there are tens of organizations in Johannesburg that are doing participant recruitment. They typically tend to do it for marketing research or other purposes. There isn't something like IST research that I know of other than IST research that's like pulling across many different recruitment avenues, everything from on the ground recruitments to radio advertisements and other sources. But I think it's a really interesting direction that we could think of in terms of how we scale cognitive science, and that rather than scaling it by increasing N on the web, we scale it geographically.
Great.